Good morning. I'd like to open with a hymn, number 473, as we enter into the memorial service for Gabriel Alvarado. Number 473, "Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow." How sweet to hold a newborn baby and feel the pride and joy He gives, but greater still the calm assurance this child can face uncertain days, because He lives, because He lives, I can face tomorrow, because He lives, all fear is gone, because I know He holds the and life is worth the living just because He lives.
Father of Gabriel, I want to thank all of you for coming today and supporting us and just really being a strong presence for us when really we're on a journey here in Glasgow. I'm Ozzy Alvarado, and many of you know that I'm here really for healing and just to get away. And then for this to happen was a very tragic surprise for our family. So we want to let you know that we're taking it day by day. We're doing okay in the sense that we know that God is in charge, that He's in control, and that it's hard to kind of find meaning sometimes and a reason why someone so young should leave this earth. I know for me, I've had to deal with the pain of feeling somewhat responsible for the accident. You know, I was driving, and I know we've had a lot of friends that have said, "Ozzy, please don't ever take the blame and don't let the guilt come upon you, and don't let the enemy do that to you." But as a father, you know, I don't think it's ever going to be easy for me to stop replaying, you know, the last few moments of Gabe and I just being together. You know, I wanted to share real briefly. First of all, I do want to tell you that we're not going to keep you here long. You know, we're just here to kind of celebrate for a few moments Gabe's life, his memory, and also just center everything with the fact that we do serve a living God. We are a Christian family, and it's all about our walk with God and what that looks like. So I want to let you know that we won't keep you here long, but we do want to share our hearts, and we want to be real with you. The first thing I want to say is that, and this may just sound odd, I've done funerals and I've never seen this happen and I've never planned it, but I want you to know the very first thing that God is welcomed in this place right now to do a miracle if He so chooses. So I want to say that publicly, because I, my wife, my family, we have faith in a God that does not change. And though this is hard to see a loved one go, we know that God could give him back. We know that God could raise him from the dead, is what I'm trying to say. Some of you are like, "It's been 6 days. He's got fluids in him." It doesn't matter. God can do miracles. It's not about me yelling at the coffin and at my son, who's really a shell, you know, just a body right now. I believe God can just surprise us at any time. So I just want to publicly say that I welcome that, that I believe in that, my family believes in that, and God, You're more than willing to do that. And if He so chooses not to, we know that we're going to see Gabriel one day in heaven, and that's okay too, because we know he's in a better place. And I've always said that if I die, never pray for me to come back, because I'm going to be okay with Jesus up in heaven. And here I am saying, you can bring him back, Lord, if you want. And I mean that, of course, as a father. But we know that Gabe is happy where he is. But God, you're welcome to do that. That's the first thing I want to share. The second thing we want to do today is we're going to just invite my family to share anything that they want. And they may not. I know my wife is not ready to do that today. She did express some of her feelings on paper. So we have my brother and my sister. They're going to come up and share what she wrote. But if anyone else at, before my sister comes up, we'll have my brother come up first. After him, if anyone wants to share from the family or any friends, if you have anything to share, we more than welcome that. You know, so Gabe, Steve, if you can come up.
Who is Gabriel Alvarado? First, I want you to know that Gabe loved God. When he gave his life to Jesus, September 2002, around age 5 and a half, we did family devotions tonight and talked about how Jesus died on the cross for our sins. After reading and talking to them, Gabe and Ashley were asked, Mike already had accepted Jesus into his heart before this, if they wanted to accept Jesus into their heart, and both said yes. Gabe wanted to pray by himself first, and he said things like, Jesus, be with me every day. I love you so much. Be with me at Thanksgiving. On my birthday and at school, he had a sincere prayer, and it was good. God's helping me read this paper as well right now. Gabe was beaming and said, I can feel Jesus in my belly, and it goes up. He was so happy and excited. He wrote a song on May 2007 when he was 10. You can take away my heart, you can take away my soul, but don't take away my Lord. I can do it without life, I can do it without my soul, but I can't do it without my Lord. I can't live without my soul. I can live without my heart, but I can't live without God. He looked up to and loved his dad. 2001, around when he was 4. At lunch, he told his dad, after I eat all my spaghetti, I will be like dad. I will be a dad and work in the office. Dad and I take turns. It's amazing. He's always had a great sense of humor, even at 8, at a young age. For one, January 2002, when he was 5, his brother Mike was asking him, do you know what game I'm playing? It's the Game Boy. Gabe butted in and said, Tom and Jerry. Mike replied, how do you know? In a bit of annoyed tone, Gabe answered, because I know everything. See the answers he gave me for Mother's Day 2010. And Christine is going to come up, meet the other half.